Well, that was dramatic. Time to go in. Hello, I'm Orenthal Dragon. Welcome to our Halloween special. What the crap am I doing? What the crap am I doing? Here I am, a fire-breathing dragon, on the night of all nights, and I'm stuck here doing this special. And to make matters worse, Tep found my book of spells, and turned me into a leftover Nightmare Before Christmas character. So apparently eating popcorn reverses me back to normal. Well, welcome to our show. You're probably wondering why we're doing this Halloween special in early November. And the answer to that is, because we feel like it! You always see Christmas stuff after the actual day, so why can't we do this special after the actual holiday? So you're probably wondering where Tep is. Well, he's experimenting with some of these chemicals over there. I'm trying to show him how to be the most evil monster of all. Then we can rule the night. How's it going over there, Tep?
Boss, should I add in more sugar or sprinkles?
That just won't do.
You're all probably expecting some kind of big adventure filled with gore and fire and flames and violence.
But I humbly advise you all to please ditch your preconceived notions that you've had for tonight. We choose to stay on topic, so we won't let any violence and gore distract us for tonight. However, Tep is experimenting with some chemicals over there that should change him into a big, powerful monster by the end of this show. I hope it works. In the meantime, I'm sure I could whip up a few stories or two. Tep, fetch my book of tales.
Here you go, boss. Here's your book of tales.
No, this is a book of Bible scriptures. That's not scary.
Well, the devil's in it. He's pretty scary.
No! Please, just go get something scarier, okay?
Right, boss. Alright, boss. Here's your really big book of tales.
Thank you, Tep. Let's see, what do we have here? Ah, here we go. This story is called Action Jackson.
Trick or treat!
Boys, come in. Boys, I'm rather disappointed in you this evening. For one, you're trick-or-treating at your own house. And two, your costumes aren't scary. I mean, I understand that you boys wanted to make your own costumes this year to save me more money, but what are you boys supposed to be?
I'm Mark Twain, the greatest 19th century writer ever.
And I'm supposed to be a ghost from Charlie Brown.
No, no, no. This is Halloween. You're supposed to be doing something, scary. So, boys, go do something scarier instead, all right?
Dad's right. We really gotta do something scarier.
I think I have an idea. Okay. I saw this in a movie one time.
Was this a Michael Bay film?
No.
Okay, good. Carry on.
I saw this in a movie. If you say the name of someone who's died, they'll come to life in this mirror. All you have to do is say it 3 times.
That's great. And this would be just enough to scare Dad.
Yeah. But who should we say?
Oh, by the way, Tim, I heard this album by Michael Jackson, and I really like Michael Jackson now, and Michael Jackson's really great.
Oh, crap!
Hey, boys, have you seen my toupee? Boom!
Hello, my children.
Note, we are well aware of the fact that Michael Jackson is in a story with 2 young boys. And with this being said, we do not intend on doing any pedophile-related jokes on Michael's behalf. Oh, crap. Does this count as one?
It's very nice to meet you.
Michael Jackson!
That's my name, child. It's very nice to meet you. What's yours?
Peter?
It's very nice to meet you, Peter.
Oh, Michael Jackson? Oh, no. We were hoping to get someone a bit scarier to scare our dad. And you just won't do. If you wouldn't mind, sir, can you please go back into the mirror?
Oh, no, child. I can't go back just yet. Yeah, he can't go back yet. Come on, stay with us.
No, I can always go back. But there's something that I have to achieve before I go. Every ghost has a destiny that they must achieve. And now that I'm a ghost, there's just one thing that I have to do.
What's that?
Well, before I died, there was this concert that I was supposed to do. It's called This Is It. I want to do it.
Wait. So you're telling me that the only way to get back is if we help you put on some kind of concert?
Well, yes, that's sort of what I just said.
And what's going to happen if we don't help you?
Then I will eat your souls!
Ah! Oh, I am so terribly sorry, children. I just really, really want to do this show.
All right, we'll help you with this show. Just please don't ever scare the crap out of me again.
Yes, sir.
Are you gonna sneeze or what?
No, I can hold it back. The doctor said if I sneezed again, my new nose might fly off.
Okay, Mr. Jackson. Now for this show, we've hired you a personal butler. I think you should be here any second.
Oh, am I at the right spot?
Bubbles!
I thought that portion of my life was over!
Oh, Bubbles, it's so nice to see you again. Would you like to do this last show with me?
Sure, just please get off.
Mr. Jackson, 5 minutes to curtain.
Okay, I'll be right out.
All right.
Though it would seem nice if I did a new song just for the occasion. I'm sure I could think of something in these next 5 minutes. Oh, Peter dropped a piece of paper. And it looks like it's a love note to this girl. And it's a song. Girl, you're oh so sweet. I could use this.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's show has been brought to you by the Please Stop Talking About Ebola Foundation. Anyways, here's Michael Jackson.
Yeah, this show better be good. I'm the only person here, and I paid $1 million for this ticket.
You make me wanna move my feet. You're the girl I want to meet. You're a tasty little treat. Yeah, girl, you're oh so fine. Your shin shivers up my spine. And if you be so kind as to let you be mine. Yeah, ooh, girl, when our arms wrap around, you're the jewel in my crown. And it's time to paint the town. Yeah, girl, you're oh so sweet. You're the girl I want to meet. 'Cause you make me move my feet. You're a tasty little treat. Yeah, I'll be there all the time, through innocence and crime. 'Cause you'd be mine. I'm making up these rhymes. Yeah, ooh yeah, ooh yeah, ooh yeah, baby. Ooh, ooh, ooh yeah, yeah.
I'd like to thank you two for helping me do this show. Why did you steal that song that I wrote?
I gotta go.
Hold on a second! You promised me a moonwalking solo! What happened to that? Oh, now you're gonna put this title card in front of me? Hey! Hey!
Hello, all you greedy little dirtbags. I'm Granny Maw Dragon, and I'm Glitch. Nobody asked you.
Oh.
Since Orenthal's in the bathroom taking a dragon-sized dump, I'm gonna tell the next story. Glitch, go get the book.
All right.
Here you go, Miss Granny Maw. Here's the Book of Tales. Oh, it's really heavy. I think I'll set it down on this table.
Uh-oh.
Thank you, Glitch. Let's see what we have here. Here's a little story called The President's a Dummy. Ain't that the truth?
The Halloween show's tonight, and I've got nothing planned. I want to do something that's scary and at the same time funny. And now I'm reciting this stupid exposition out loud. What's wrong with me? Hey, Fenton?
I'm sorry I woke you up from your beauty sleep, but I need your help. Tonight's the big show, and I want to do something that's both scary and funny. You think maybe you could help me go into town and we can pick out something? Alright, let's go.
Hey, Fenton, where's a good place that can sell some scary crap? That's right, Walmart! Ah, here it is, Walmart.
Okay, slow down. Slow down, get down! Okay, Gratch driving the car scene, take two and action.
Ah, here we are, Walmart.
Slow down, slow down.
Good.
I hope these signs aren't intimidating my customers.
Excuse me, sir.
Oh, hello. Welcome to Walmart. How may I help you?
Hey, you look familiar. Aren't you that guy that used to hate everybody and terrorize my friends?
Yes, that was me. But I'm just too worn out. But at least I am still contributing to the evil world. I mean, look at me. I'm working at Walmart.
Pretty evil. So, sir, I was just wondering if you had anything that could help me out with this comedy act that I'm doing. It's supposed to be both funny and scary.
Well, let's take a look at these options. We have here a joke book by Adam Sandler, filled with the most terrible jokes ever. That should scare people.
No, try something else.
We have this body wash made out of poisonous apples.
Try something else.
A baseball that was thrown at Adolf Hitler.
Try something else.
The American flag, the most despicable country of all. Pretty evil, eh?
Yeah, pretty evil, but not scary enough.
This ventriloquist dummy seems very nice.
Oh, yeah, I want to buy that dummy, please.
But there's one thing that I must warn you about.
What's that?
When you purchase at Walmart, customer satisfaction is not always guaranteed, especially with this particular dummy.
What's wrong with him?
Oh, what was that thing? Something I was supposed to tell you. Something about a curse or something like that. Oh yeah, no refunds.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm gonna take him home.
But little does he know, it's cursed by a former president.
Were you talking to me, sir?
No, of course not. Have fun with your dummy.
Thank you.
I am not a crook.
Gonna go take a crap. Fenton, what do you mean there's something wrong with my dummy? You're the dummy, dummy. It's just a puppet, and as everyone knows, there's nothing to be afraid of puppets. Okay.
The Cold War isn't thawing. It's burning.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? May I have your attention, please? Will the real Slim Shady please stand up? Please stand up? Please stand up? I'm sorry, I had to use that joke. Anyways, it's time to start our first annual Sneeple Spook Pageant, starting off with a costume contest. And the nominees are Andrei wearing his Batman mask, Caveman dressed up as a cop, Sally wearing this creepy Guy Fox mask, Dr. Clark with a knife through his head, and Vince the Janitor.
Oh, come on!
And the winner is Vince the Janitor!
There goes my last lingering ounce of self-esteem.
Hey Clark, I gotta ask you something. How did you get that knife through your head? Okay.
Please get me to a doctor.
I thought you were a doctor.
I thought so too.
And now for the entertainment portion of our evening.
I take it laughing at me wasn't enough.
Max the Mouse will recite a poem about Halloween.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Max the Mouse, and I'd just like to tell you that Halloween is a celebration for Satanists, and anybody who celebrates is going to go with Satan.
The religious type always ruin the fun. Hey, Andrei, that's Batman! Sure. Could you please escort Max the Mouse to the good old Sneeple Cannon?
With pleasure! Alright, you're coming with me.
Wait a second, we have a Sneeple Cannon?
Yes, it would appear as though we do have a Sneeple Cannon. Alright, get in there, you.
Loop. I can see my house from here!
Well, that certainly was random. Anyways, on with our show. Our next act, the Gratch, will perform ventriloquism with his new dummy, Charlie McCarthy. Oh, Charlie, did you know that Jehovah's Witnesses don't celebrate Halloween? Because I'm sure they must hate when people come knocking at their door. Am I right?
Communist China is only getting bigger.
What?
Great Scott! That almost sounds like Richard Nixon! Good impression!
Oh, please bear with me, folks. I did not write that. In fact, let me take my hand out of him.
I am not a crook.
It is Richard Nixon! That thing is possessed!
I am not a crook. The communists are taking over. Give me back those tapes. I hate the communists.
Eat lead, Nixon.
Oh!
Quickly, take him to the Sneeple Cannon before he tries to enforce gun control.
Everybody's a communist.
Now how on earth did I get over here? Anybody seen Michelle?
Wait a second, President Obama? But he's not dead yet.
Maybe not, but his dignity is. We're doomed.
Oh, silly average American consumer. When will you ever learn? Once you purchase from Walmart, your life will never be happy. Oh, I think I feel a sneeze coming on. Achoo!
Oh, you're still here. Well, perfect. Because Tep is almost done with his evil concoction. And very soon, he'll become the most evil creature known to man. Tep, what time is it?
1/2 past a grain of sand, boss.
Perfect. Just enough time to read another story. Let's see here. This one's called The Walking Dead, Before It Was Cool.
Okay, Mr. Zombister, welcome to your first day at Moonbucks Coffee.
Yeah, whatever.
Do you know how to brew the coffee?
Yeah, dude, I've been brewing coffee since before it was cool.
Okay, well, I'll just leave you to it.
Yeah. Order up!
This better be the best cup of coffee I've ever tasted.
Oh,
Let's see what's on the news today. Probably another Kim Kardashian story, no doubt.
A new epidemic has been discovered that most people have dubbed the name...
Zombie-itis!
Zombie-itis is commonly spread amongst hipsters. However, it can be spread towards normal people as well. This disease is very contagious, and to spot people who have it, they are dressed up as hipsters and they're foaming at the mouth. It is said that this disease started earlier today at Moonbucks Coffee. However, because I don't drink coffee, I'm sure I won't be affected. Ain't that right, Mr. Cameraman Norman?
Alex, board up these doors, okay?
How about we get some Starbucks instead?
Alright guys, we're the last four people on Earth that haven't been turned into zombies. Yeah, and all this not drinking coffee sure has made me tired.
So, should we start repopulating?
What? No!
I'm sorry, I haven't slept in days. I don't know what I'm saying anymore.
You know, they say when you haven't slept in days, you start having thoughts of killing yourself. No, but I have had thoughts of killing you.
What?
Nothing.
Guys!
Ah!
I know how to get people back to normal. All you have to do is kill the head zombie, and I know where he lives. Come follow me.
Oh, why thank you. Oh, just one more thing. Morty!
I'm sorry, but I told you, the urge to kill has really increased these last couple days.
Okay, guys, I'm going to go take a peek out the window and see how many zombies are out there.
Alright, be careful.
Bike riding is eco-friendly. Who wants to come listen to alternative rock in my parents' basement?
Okay, if we sneak out the back door, because the front door is too mainstream, we might be able to make it to my car.
Oh, really? Where's your car?
Take a look out that window.
Oh my god! Andrei, how on earth can you afford that?
Let's just say I had to sell my body.
Oh.
To science?
Oh.
Hey, you guys want to go stop by Starbucks real quick? Andrei! Oh yeah, the apocalypse.
Your car is killing the environment.
Well, we have bursted into every house but this one. So he must live here.
Oh, the scar feels so nice up against my dead leathery skin. Oh.
Hey, Zombuster, did you remember to fold those towels?
Yeah, Mom.
No, you haven't, because I'm standing outside the shower, freezing my butt off.
Dude, get off my back.
Move out of my basement.
No.
Excuse me, are you Zombuster, the head zombie?
Yeah, why?
Because I'm here to kill you.
Just a second before you kill me. Perhaps a world with zombie hipsters isn't so bad after all. I mean, the air smells much, much sweeter. And the environment is doing much nicer. And our clothes are so much greater. And our bikes, so much more efficient than cars. So dude, what do you say? Is being a hipster so bad?
Yes.
Okay, Granny Ma. In a few minutes or so, Tep should be done with his evil potion. And he shall reveal his new powerful evil form.
Yeah, this better be scary. I mean, I've seen a lot of Chucky movies, and this better top it. Welp, see ya.
Glitch, go apprehend him.
Okie dokie.
Up right there.
Oh, goody, an appetizer.
Pray for me.
All right, time to reverse this.
Uh-oh.
I never thought I'd have to use this potion. Tep, you've gone completely berserk. That's why you must feel the love.
Huh?
Aww. Boss, why did you destroy my evil power like that? Didn't you see how evil I was?
Yes, yes, I saw. But two things you must know, Tep.
What's that?
Number one, you were too evil. And nobody, and I mean nobody, can possibly be more evil than Orenthal Dragon. And another thing, I have to learn how to accept you for who you are. You're good on the inside, and I need to accept that.
But boss...
Yes?
One thing, you created me, and if I could be as evil as I just was, that means that you did something right.
I guess it does.